Let's make corn. Disregard everything on the internet about putting the corn in the microwave. Do not do that. You can comment below about how I'm wrong, but don't put the corn in the microwave and then squeeze it out of the thing. It's ridiculous. It takes 2 seconds to shuck corn. What you're gonna do is this, okay? You're gonna hold the corn by the little wispy ends and you're gonna break it in half like this and you're gonna pull down the sides like this, okay? And I'm gonna take it to the microwave. I usually make people go to what we call the CSA, the corn shucking area, if they're doing me the favor of shucking the corn, because it makes a big mess. Then you're gonna take a cloth and go like this, which takes the silks off. The silks will usually boil away, but it's better if there's a ton of silks to get them off. And you need some physical strength. You know, my friend David, we were shucking corn together, me, some other guy, and David. And David's a brilliant designer, and we shucked like 8 ears of corn, and David was like wiping every, you know, like, and he goes, oh, I only did one. But it was funny because his was the more perfect one, obviously. And sometimes when you cook corn, you can break it in half, so you have easier to manage pieces of corn for people. But anyway, this is corn, so corn, shucked. You're almost ready to serve. And this is the trick with corn. You've had the water boiling, you're boiling salted water. Now, I don't know why I do this. I think I saw somebody do this. I like to put a little cream in the water. Don't ask me. And then you wanna make sure it's boiling. You're gonna go like this. And then guess what you're gonna do? You're gonna turn the heat off. That corn is gonna be ready in about 4 minutes. Cooks so fast. They overcook it, I think, most of the time. By the time you set everything out, the corn is ready. So there's a cool thing you can do with butter, which is fun. It's kind of fun, especially if you left butter out by accident. What you do is you take, if you're really good at chopping, you chop up herbs, chives, tarragon, rosemary, anything. Chop it up super, super fine, and in a bowl, mix it up with that softened butter. And then put it on a greaseproof piece of paper, I mean like a parchment paper, and you can shape it into a shape, or you can put it into a little cup and put it in the fridge. And then you can serve your corn with sort of herbed flavored butter, or just salt and pepper butter. Some people roll it into balls with cellophane, into a sort of sausages and recool it. It's delicious, and also salted, peppered, herbed butter with fresh corn at the end of summer. Come on, that's fantastic. It's delicious. It's called compound butter. Look it up, it's cool, it's really interesting. Here's my corn. So I'm just gonna shake off the inexplicably creamy water. Whoops. And then I'm gonna put it in this bowl, which is ever so slightly too big, but it's beautiful against the corn, I think. The Last of the Summer Corn by Randy Sharp, Incorporated. I don't know why I do this. I think I saw somebody do this. I like to put a little cream in the water. Don't ask me.